Penguin Random House Audio presents Your Special, Advice for Humans from Coolman Coffeedan, by Danny Casale. Read for you by Danny Casale, Sean Kenin, Isabella Addison, Spencer Goldman, Seth Hirsch, Chad Lebaron, Xanthe Paige, and Blake Rosier. Before we start this book, did anybody lose this iguana?
Hello.
He says his name is Alfred. He's excellent on the piano, a master of the ivories, some may say. He's also fluent in Spanish. Pretty impressive. I'm sure his owner is worried sick. If you have any information, please call my house phone. My mom will probably answer. Tell her you're calling about Señor Iggy, the cool nickname I gave him, and she'll probably hand the phone over to me. Please call anytime besides Sundays. That's when she meets up with the gals for brunch or something. Okay, now we can start. Chapter 1. You're Not Alone. Hey, thanks for purchasing this audiobook. Things can get pretty lonely in an audiobook app. You wouldn't believe the amount of people that just scroll past this audiobook and don't even bother reading the description or even listening to the free sample. But you did. I mean, you probably bought it. Unless it was gifted to you. That's really cool. Thanks for buying me. You're a really cool person, so I should consider myself honored to be hanging out with you. That is, unless you're a hacker who broke into the audiobook servers late at night, dodged high-security firewalls, and nabbed this incredible novel right out of the cloud without leaving a trace. In that case, I definitely have a few questions. Like, how many books do you have to steal to be considered an official book robber? 10? 20? Does it say certified book robber on your business card? How's the book robber job market looking nowadays? What was your biggest book heist? Are there movies about book heists? That would be pretty cool because you could dress up as a librarian super spy in disguise. I would totally watch that movie. Anyways, I'm sure you're an upstanding citizen who paid for this audiobook. Or had someone who's really awesome buy it for you, and fully expect to enjoy the many life lessons I have in store for you. Sometimes life can be weird. Good weird, bad weird, or just plain weird weird. There's no stopping life from being weird. The best we can do is be prepared for whatever weird stuff life is gonna throw our way. It's not uncommon for life to surprise us with this weird stuff, and there's always an important lesson to be had. Oftentimes, we learn these important lessons from our mistakes. But it doesn't hurt to have a few lessons in your pocket already. Pre-mistake, if you will. It's like if you fall off a cliff, at least you have some bandages in your backpack to hold you over. Maybe that was a bad example. Please don't fall off any cliffs.
But what is a naked cat thing going to teach me? What experience does it even have? I'm a human with real human issues, and it just told me that a bandage is the cure to falling off a cliff. I want a refund.
Look, I may just be a naked cat thing, but I like to think I have some wisdom to impart to your human brain. I have thoughts, feelings, fears, and insecurities too. You don't necessarily have to be human to feel. Just ask this houseplant.
I love poetry.
I know I may look different from you, but please don't think of me as different. When you meet someone new, all too often people will try to identify as many differences as they can. All that does is set you up to have way less friends. I'm sure we have a lot in common, actually. We probably both love delicious food and think puppies are adorable. Think of me as a friend who will guide you through the wonderful world of life lessons that you should definitely learn now rather than later. Registered trademark. I would love for you to have a better understanding of what to do when life gets weird. Hopefully, when we're done spending our time together, you have learned a thing or two more about yourself than if we didn't hang out at all. We should start now, though. I have plans to go to a movie and it starts soon, and I just cannot miss it. I bought these tickets like 3 months ago. Luckily, we can talk as I make my way over to the cinema. Let's go. Oh my gosh, a bunch of aliens! Are you guys alright?
Yes, thank you.
I told you we need to get that broken computer chip checked out. I was too nervous to call the mechanic. You know I have phone call anxiety. Do you guys need help with directions or something? I have lessons to teach and a movie to catch, so I really need to get going. Yes, directions would be great.
We are lost and scared.
Well, when you think about it, it's okay to feel lost and scared sometimes.
No, like, we are literally millions of miles lost. Our home planet is in a different dimension.
Oh, okay. Lucky for you, I have this map of the universe. Patent pending. Okay, so here's Earth. We are here. A little bit beyond there is Planet Pizza, followed by the hot dog spaceship. And then right before Planet Ice Cream is Tree People Planet. Oh, I remember that planet. Everyone is a tree there.
Yes, we remember. You kept making tree puns.
Nothing beats comedy. You know, I never thought about how small Earth is. But looking at this map, I'm realizing that there's so much out there that I often don't think about. It makes all my problems look pretty small.
What problems do you have? We are literally light years from our home.
I don't know. I just get caught up in my own head. Sometimes I make my problems seem a lot bigger than they actually are. I should remind myself that there's so many creatures out there, dealing with their own stuff.
Meanwhile, on Tree People Planet.
I feel like you just used me for my branches!
As a squirrel, I found that deeply offensive!
We have a tendency to make our small problems bigger than they actually are. Everyone's going through something. But it's important to remember that what might seem like a big problem to you is tiny compared to someone else's. Not to say your problems aren't valid, but keeping other people in mind never hurts and is a great way to keep everything in perspective. Anyways, it looks like you're gonna wanna go that way. Follow the North Star and make a left at the Little Dipper. If you see Planet Pizza, you've gone too far.
Thanks for the directions and the free life lesson.
Yeah, I feel guided in more ways than one.
Let's blow this popsicle planet, boys.
Wow, I love foreigners. Chapter 2. You're Not Ugly. So yeah, this movie is gonna be great. It's an indie film about love or whatever. I'm going because when I see a really good movie, it feels like it has read my mind. That's an amazing feeling. I like going to the movies alone because I really enjoy the quality time with myself. I feel like alone time isn't nearly as socially acceptable as it should be. People think they should feel sad for those who are alone, like it's a weird thing to do. Don't get me wrong, I love when I get to see the people I care about, but I also love being alone. You get to learn about yourself and think about things that you never thought about before. It's like going on a date with yourself. Even though it's just me, I usually buy two tickets. The only reason I do that is because I usually order a bag of popcorn so large that it legally qualifies as a small child. I would invite you, but I need that extra seat for my popcorn. I tried getting a smaller size, but it always disappears before the movie even starts, so...
Excuse me.
Whoa, hey, turtle.
I couldn't help but notice that you walked right past me without saying anything. No hello, no wink, not even a nod.
Sorry.
Is it because I'm ugly?
No way, it's not that. I just had some stuff on my mind.
Taxes, shrimp, the pyramids.
Haha, dancing monkey.
Oh, it's okay. Sorry if I came off as rude. Sometimes I just have really bad days where my self-confidence feels like it's below zero. It's no one's fault in particular, just me getting in my own head. On days like today, I can't even bring myself to look anybody in the eye. I also think everybody is making fun of me, even though they probably aren't. I know it sounds ridiculous, but I would pay $1 million just to have some amount of confidence. No matter how hard I try, I still feel like the ugliest girl in the world.
Hey. It's totally normal to feel like that sometimes. Occasionally, having a bad day or two is just what we signed up for when we were put on this planet. it even makes us stronger once we overcome those bad days. Recently, I was staring at myself in the mirror for what felt like hours just because I had a pimple on my forehead. It felt like my world was falling apart, even though it was such a microscopic issue. I eventually got over it because I saw a cloud that looked like a cowboy hat. However, feeling like you're having too many of these bad days is a problem and needs to be taken care of properly. For example, what do you do when you fall off a cliff?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.